I'm Emma. I'm a graduate student here at Harvard Medical School in the Silver Lab. And what the lab does here is we make cells do things that cells don't normally do. What I do personally is make mammalian cells make new steroid drugs. I've always known I sort of liked science, but I never was sure, finding things out, learning new things. And I wanted a job where I could learn new things every day. I've always known I could do some things that other people couldn't do, and particularly growing up with a sister with learning disabilities, it was pretty evident that I could, I was pretty focused and I liked this sort of work. And I just knew I wanted to do something that would help a lot of people and that I, it was kind of my response. If I could, I should. Typically, my days right now involve mostly bench work and planning experiments. So if I'm planning and setting something up, I'm working on my computer, thinking about what types of enzymes I want to put in my cells to make the new steroids, what kinds of new steroids would be most useful perhaps to try to make, and then planning out ordering pieces of DNA online, ordering chemicals from online. I know when you think steroids, you think athletes cheating. But actually, steroid drugs are super important. If you have arthritis, they're the main anti-inflammatory that people use. If you have, say, anemia, you're given those same steroids that athletes use to cheat to increase your blood count. There's a lot of useful things that steroids do, but the problem is they have a ton of side effects. And so you might think, what if we make new types of steroids and maybe they'll have fewer side effects and we can check them all? The problem is they're really hard to make. So I'm pioneering a new method to make steroids way more quickly. And that way you can test new products without having to go through, say, a year of chemists messing around with this molecule. So when it comes to steroid drugs, actually, I got on the project just because I was interested in drugs and thought the method of making them in cells was really cool. But then actually I came home for Thanksgiving right after starting this project and found out that my cousin, well, she's more like my aunt, who has type 1 diabetes, her arthritis had gotten much worse, and the anti-inflammatories they wanted to put her on were steroid drugs. The problem is that the steroid drugs, they worked great for the arthritis, but they have a side effect that changes how your blood sugar works. And I realized that even though I didn't start out thinking I had much personal connection to these drugs are so common. A lot of the problems in science are so wide-reaching that you're pretty quickly going to find somebody who would be directly impacted by your work. Misconceptions people might have, that it's lonely. It's not lonely. There's so many people around. I mean, if you are the sort of person who wants some personal space, yeah, you can get that. But our lab, we're always doing lunch together, hanging out, and you can be terrible at arithmetic. I'm actually pretty terrible at arithmetic, and be good at math and be good at logic, just not particularly great with numbers. And so you can be a physicist, a chemist, a biologist, anything. Just because you're not great at math doesn't mean you shouldn't consider going into a math-heavy discipline like physics.